Inotify is a Linux kernel subsystem that acts to extend file systems to notice changes to the file system, and report those changes to applications. It replaces an earlier facility, dnotify, which had similar goals. Inotify was created by John McCutchan, and it was merged into the Linux kernel mainline in kernel version 2.6.13, released on August 29, 2005. Later kernel versions included further improvements. The required library interfaces were added into the GNU C Library in its version 2.4, released in March 2006, while the support for Inotify was completed in glibc version 2.5, released in September 2006. One major use is in desktop search utilities like Beagle, where its functionality permits re-indexing of changed files without scanning the file system for changes every few minutes, which would be very inefficient. By being told directly by the kernel that a file has changed, indexing utilities can achieve change to re-indexing times of only about a second. Inotify can also be used to automatically update directory views, reload configuration files, log changes, backup, synchronize, and upload. Limitations. Limitations imposed by Inotify include the following. Inotify does not support recursively watching directories, meaning that a separate Inotify watch must be created for every subdirectory. Inotify does report some but not all events in SYSFS and PROCFS. Notification via Inotify requires the kernel to be aware of all relevant file system events, which is not always possible for networked file systems such as NFS, where changes made by one client are not immediately broadcast to other clients. Rename events are not handled directly. That is, Inotify issues two separate events that must be examined and matched in a context of potential race conditions. History: July 2004, the first release announcement, August 29, 2005. Linux kernel version 2.6.13 released, containing merged Inotify code, March 2006, GNU C Library version 2.4 released, bringing initial Inotify support, September 2006, glibc version 2.5 released, bringing complete Inotify support. Advantages over dnotify. There are a number of advantages when using Inotify when compared to the older dnotify API that it replaced. With dnotify, a program had to use one file descriptor for each directory that it was monitoring. This can become a bottleneck since the limit of file descriptors per process could be reached. Later, fanotify was created to overcome this issue. The use of file descriptors along with dnotify also proved to be a problem when using removable media. Devices could not be unmounted since file descriptors kept the resource busy. Another drawback of dnotify is the level of granularity, since programmers can only monitor changes at the directory level. To access detailed information about the environmental changes that occur when a notification message is sent, a stat structure must be used. This is considered a necessary evil in that a cache of stat structures has to be maintained. For every new stat structure generated, a comparison is run against the cached one. The Inotify API uses fewer file descriptors, allowing programmers to use the established select and poll interface, rather than the signal notification system used by dnotify. This also makes integration with existing select or poll-based libraries easier. See also File Alteration Monitor, GMIN, DMAPI, KQUEUE, FSEVENTS. References. External links. Kernel Corner, Intro to Inotify by Robert Love, LWN article on Inotify watching file system events with Inotify, IBM article Monitor Linux file system events with Inotify. File system notification, Part 1, an overview of dnotify and Inotify. LWN.net 2014.